Hey guys, Ramon here. So I recently went to go check out the new James Bond movie, Skyfall. And from the minute I decided to go, I felt like I was already a part of this movie. I think I'm gonna check out this movie. Forget this.
Where you going?
Damn! I never liked him anyway. Come on, let's go! No!
So it went exactly like that, except for maybe the girl, the cars, and the guns. But besides that, that's exactly how my experience was to go get these tickets. Alright guys, so there might be some spoilers in this. The story of Skyfall is pretty much about a former MI6 agent that was left for dead. And he didn't die, so he comes back and tries to get revenge on MI6. He ends up targeting agents, killing them, and he eventually tries to kill M as well. And at that point, James Bond isn't having it, so the entire mission is basically, I have to stop this guy from ruining MI6 and the security of our nation. So I felt like this Bond kind of went back to its roots. It was more traditional. They brought back some of the older characters like Q and Miss Moneypenny. They brought back the use of gadgets, which was good, but the gadgets they brought out were kind of lame. A radio transmitter, which was kind of like, it didn't do anything special. A gun that you would have palm print ID access. But it didn't make sense because he ended up losing the gun like 20 minutes after he got it. So it was a little disappointing. So the film is titled Skyfall. Now, you know, I thought maybe Skyfall was the name of the mission, or maybe it was the name of a secret weapon. Skyfall is the name of James Bond's family's real estate where he used to live as a kid, which is where the film comes to a conclusion. So I was a little disappointed about that. The thing I did like though was that they actually went back and they added little bits of humor to it. And it wasn't like that campy kind of thing. It was little bits of humor that added character development. And I felt like character wise with the villain and everybody else, they did a good job. There was enough talking time. So that was a positive for it. So while there was a lot of action sequences and it was pretty cool, like all the destruction and things that Bond had to go through, there were certain times where I felt it really dragged. At one point, literally, the heroes were chased into a house and they had to set up traps for the people that were coming after them. And I was trying to figure it out. I was like, am I watching a James Bond movie or is this, you know, am I watching Home Alone? So usually in James Bond films, the villains are killed in these really over-the-top dramatic ways. But this film was a little bit different. Instead of falling off of a building or getting sucked into an airplane propeller or something, you know, along those lines, you get stabbed in the back by 007. That's pretty lame. It's even more lame if you never saw it coming. So at the end of the day, I give Skyfall a B+. There was a lot of cool action sequences. It was a lot of nostalgia. They were using a lot of the format, the way the old Bond films were done, and it was really cool. the last 20, 30 minutes of the film was a little fuzzy, kind of bothered me a little bit, especially the conclusion with the villain. But other than that, if you're a Bond fan or you're not a Bond fan, I would still tell you to check it out. It was a good action film, and I'm looking forward to what they come up with next time for Bond.